You always this hard on Thor? Seems like you're mad at him or something.
Ooh, getting nosy. Getting personal. No, I get it, but it's nothing like that. It's... Well, to be honest, it's the only language he understands. I'm serious. Go ahead and try being nice to him. See where that gets you.
Huh. Dragon skull in the library. No big deal. So, about the sword. Is Ingrid the name of the soul inside it? I wonder why I can't hear her.
Soul? Who said anything about... Look, son. Some free advice. You don't want to let anyone catch you talking to your sword, all right? It's a bad look. All right, come along, Hugin.
How much time does he spend reading? Kinda jealous.
Are you trying to make friends now?
Well, I just aided the Allfather. You said that makes us allies.
Yes, as long as you had no treacherous... Interesting. You don't really know quite what you're doing here anymore. Sometimes I envy the Allfather. He always sees the best in people. While all I see is what people really are. Nobody ever says what they mean. Some lie to the world. Some lie to themselves and don't even know it. And then there is you. You don't know what you want. You don't even know who you are. But I hope you do know this. I will be watching.
More politely, I'd assume. Except considerably more politely, yes.
Days get colder, and the nights get longer.
But...
Hey, you're back!
How was it? Did Father behave himself?
Yeah, I mean, better than I would have expected, I guess.
Is that the sword from Grandfather's study?
Oh, yeah. Her name's Ingrid.
Hi, Ingrid. Wow. Allfather must really trust you. Well, glad you survived your first day.
Hey, me too.
Tomorrow, we talk about Valkyries.
Definitely.
I'm not thrilled. Did you think that I would be?
Well, it's pretty good sword.
I'm not angry. I'm concerned. You know that's not what I want for her.
You don't want her to have a sword.
But it's not about having a sword. It's about what you use it for. I think you know what I mean.
Yeah, I do. And I don't want that for her either, okay? You don't have to worry. She's a smart girl. Smarter than her father.
Well, when you're right, you're right. come here.
Well, this has been a weird day. Exactly. Nicely equipped. What needs work?
Good morning, brother. No news, I'm afraid.
I have a plan.
Do you now?
The Nords. You found them once. Could you do so again?
I could try, but I don't see how that
they
would help.
They are the fates of these lands, are they not? I would know what they know.
You may not find them cooperative.
As long as I find them, where do we search?
Midgard. But if Atreus is an Asgard, there's no getting him back without an army. We should be raising one.
Yes, nothing like a catastrophic war to improve the situation. The boy seems quite capable. Perhaps if you simply give him some time.
You are not free of blame here. You encouraged his foolishness, his confusion. I do not seek war. But if Odin has stolen my son, do not doubt the lengths I will go to.
Your nature has always been clear, Kratos. But you, Freya. War is a first resort. That's not the Freya I knew. I hope the Norns can give you the counsel you need. Perhaps mine is no longer of use here.
Tyr, stop. This is no time to divide ourselves further. Come, sit, please.
You have been quiet.
Frankly, I'm surprised you of all people would seek out fate. But your instincts haven't let us down so far. Let's find the Norns.
Hoped to help the boy find his answers. And I failed. What's my role in all this now?
Tyr, you're at the center of this. You always have been. That's why Odin imprisoned you in the first place. He's terrified of you.
I doubt that very much.
It's the truth. And not just because of prophecies. No one has ever united the realms as you once did.
That is not who I am anymore.
I know you feel that way now. I've lost myself before. More than once, but believe me, there is something beyond that.
And what is that?
Purpose. Purpose is the path that leads you to yourself.
So you would have me accept my fate? Lead your armies into war, secure your vengeance.
If securing our justice is not your purpose, then find another, for your own sake.
Don't try to talk me into coming. The Norns and their tales of our fates, it's everything I've walked away from.
When you're ready to seek the Norns, I'm with you. Just taking a moment. This? Only when I worry.
How would Atreus get to Asgard?
I'm sorry, but you'd have to ask Odin. He's got control of every path. I know how highly you esteem our expertise on such things, so I'm sure that's disappointing. He's just been one step ahead of us.
Hang on! I got something for you. Sindri!
Coming!
Before you go traipsing off into the dawn, I thought you'd like to have this back. Well, don't go getting too cheery about it. But you're welcome.
I've collected what we need to find the Norns. Shall we go?
Neathoak.
I suspect we may have consequences to look forward to.
Squirrel.
Ah, Master Kratos, my apologies. Madam Neathoak's disappearance weighs heavily on my mind.
She, friend of yours?
Less a friend than another longtime tenant of the tree. She was here even before I arrived, and that was ages ago. To even think something could keep her away from her babies. Terrible, just terrible.
They're sweating bricks on Main Street, and you're gonna go hit his chime right now?
Dick move.
He isn't coming. What do you need to talk to him for, anyway?
Alfheim? What's there?
We still have unfinished business there. There's still that secret elven library in Alfheim.
Lead the way.
I've been studying, and I can forge some new equipment for you.
Thank you.
Lads, I thought death had cured me of my appetite, but damn if I can't stop thinking about the smell of tear stew. Awakened a fair few culinary cravings, then. Black pudding, haggis and neeps, oh!
Porridge and honey.
What about you, brother? Any pre-Fimble winter foods you're aching for?
Olives.
The hell's an olive?
Much of the sand has been cleared away, but another storm rages beyond that pass, which must mean...
Another Hafgufa!
Odd. It looks as though the Light Elf sealed off this section of the Barrens. Why?
Luckily for us, a very considerate goddess has enhanced our magic chisel, and we can unseal it.
My. That is lucky.
The Forbidden Sands lay beyond.
Contested territory, according to Bela. And another storm to endure.
Mekki!
I must say, I think we make a good team. With my brains, Kratos' brawn, and my lady's,
Wisdom? Magic? Ability to tolerate you for long periods of time?
I was going to say brutality.
That works.
Freyr so revered here so quickly upon his first arrival?
Well, to begin with, it wasn't his first arrival. Very few know this, but Freyr was one of the earliest visitors to Alfheim, back in the dawn of realm travel.
Oh? But before my time. Do tell.
We believed for a long time that all the giants had died in the Flood, until one of them appeared in Vanaheim. Her name was Gerd. And she came offering to teach us the secrets of traveling between realms using Bifrost Light. Freyr became immediately infatuated with her. He always yearned to wander, and along came someone who could truly show him how. So, wander they did, exploring the world tree from root to branch. But one day, it came time for Gerd to wander away. Freyr was heartbroken. And resolved himself to perform some great feat to win her back. He set his aim on the grandest of gestures. He intended to be the first to find the elusive source of Bifrost Light. And he succeeded, although quite by accident. Freyr believed he navigated best while fortified by a potent blend of Vanir herbs. When he wandered. And he managed to wander from the World Tree directly into the Lake of Souls. The elves have never seen anybody come out of the lake before, so it got some attention.
Oh, that is bloody hilarious.
I don't know whether he worked his charms at that point or they just assumed him to be a great deity. But of course, he hadn't made this journey in search of responsibility, so he didn't stick around long. Still, the legend of his manifestation was passed along through the ages. It even endured after the Great Division, remembered by Light and Dark Elf alike. So when at last he returned, he was uniquely situated to gain the trust of both sides and help to create a truce. The problem was, both sides trusted only him. So the peace could only last as long as he stayed around to keep it. And with the long war dragging on without an end in sight, I suppose making any kind of peace was an irresistible notion for him. Even if it meant having to rule.
More Draugr crawling out of the bloody ground.
Another Draugr to the left!
Gods for the death of her family, and has been haphazardly wreaking her vengeance on anything within arm's reach. Even death didn't stop her.
I know.
Lady, I was curious about some of the flora we've encountered on our travels.
And you will remain curious. It's not my job to teach you everything, Mimir.
Look, I was just asking.
And you have been told.
Well, you can say that again.
Force of habit, I suppose.
Since I don't sleep anymore. Oh, it's far more confounding that I'm the tired one. I've seen you stay awake for days at a time without so much as a drooping eyelid. Not even a nap.
Gods do not nap.
Oh, tell that to Thor.
Thank you.
Freya, you once survived a giant's corpse to stop a certain fight we won't talk about. Could you call on that power again?
Maybe. Do you have a massive giant's corpse for me to revive?
No.
Well, there you go.
Kratos, tell me of an adversary from your homeland. It will serve us well if I understand more of your battle tactics.
There was Medusa, queen of the Gorgons. Her gaze turned men to stone. A mirror would turn her own powers against her. Or, you may remove her head, but that is the hard way.
Which did you choose?
The hard way.
Forget I asked.
Yeah!
ever written poetry of your own, brother?
No.
Well, ask a stupid question.
I remember when Freya and I traveled to this realm as children. The desert was healthy and full of life back then. I can't help but fear that era has ended for good and our efforts here are futile.
It's a fair concern. Healing this land will take more than a pair of singing half-goofer. But I have to believe, in the long run, we're doing right by Alpine.
Well, best we start looking for a way underground.
Keep a lookout for a cave!
I hope Freyr will appreciate our work here in the desert. I wonder if he knows how poorly this realm has fared in his absence.
Aye. Hearing the Song of the Sands again is a rare privilege, even if it's only a solo act.
Or a duet. Once this Hofgufa is free. This architecture. It is not of the Dark Elves.
An abandoned ancient settlement, by the looks of it. Built long before the Lightwell's creation.
More hive matter as well.
I'd say we're on the right track then.
It from down here.
This kind of hive material is sensitive to sound. How odd. Came here with you and Atreus, I assumed the absence of Alfheim's light was an aberration. I didn't realize it was covered by hive matter.
Aye. And as far as the Dark Elves are concerned, it's that light column in the center of the temple that's the aberration. Just look at how old some of these surfaces are. Far older than the Lightwell, or even our trapped half-giver for that matter.
That's quite the empathetic perspective, Mimir.
Well, dangle from a burly god's backside for a few winters, and you'll find yourself looking for all sorts of new perspectives.
For that. Maybe the Twilight Stone on the ground will help. Well, there you go.
Another wretch to the left.
Travel underneath the Barons, do they?
Territory changes hands often in Alfheim. Or so it appears.
Bigbeard did mention that these ruins have historical significance for the Light Elves. I assume they're only here to keep intruders out.
Well, at least they tried.
I suspect the corpse below would disagree.
Look there. That hive doesn't like sound, remember?
Good eye. Let's continue, shall we?
These half goofers will allow them to breed again. It was a dazzling display once. The skies of Alfheim filled with their song.
I imagine it's the lack of fresh light that's caused this pair to grow abnormally large. No use in having babies if there's nothing for them to feed on.
Trying to protect their children from a harsh world. I can relate.
Huh?
I wonder if these two comprehend the choice they face once freed.
What choice do you speak of?
The life cycle of the Hofgufa. In order to breed, they must pass on their light to their children.
And without light, they will die.
I suppose that's all any of us can hope for in the end. That our death has purpose. That we can live on through our children. Given another chance, I know what choice I would make. Almost there.
Back to the surface, then.
Used in many of Freyr's blessings, I imagine.
Fate of these creatures. It reminds me of a story.
Does it?
There once was a blacksmith whose king commanded him to construct a box that could contain all the evils of the world. But no metal could hold such a power. So the blacksmith used the flame.
Is this a story meant to ease my grief?
Perhaps it is just a story. A way to pass the time.
I appreciate the sentiment, but... well, your stories...
What about my stories?
I wouldn't exactly call them a comfort.
Fair. Mimir is the better storyteller.
Now don't sell yourself short, brother. You've come a long way from the days of laconic fables.
It's okay. Finish your story, Kratos.
The blacksmith's daughter was the key to unlocking the box. He died trying to protect her from those who would open it.
Well, at least it's a relatable story.
Years we've overstayed our welcome in Alfheim.
Storm.
Take solace in knowing you did what you thought was best for your son's safety. Even these creatures know. There is little choice for a parent. You are not alone.
I'm not, am I? And now neither are they.
Get misty. It's beautiful.
Thank you, Kratos. This land sings once more. We've done good here.
No rush to leave yet, is there? Who knows what kind of adventures await us in a freshly lit barrens?
A light elf statue in the desert. Odd.
Aye. Here's the sanctum Bigvir spoke of in Vanai.
What is that?
A phantom! Rogue magic! Aim for the runic core!
Bloody hell! Look at that thing!
It's vulnerable when it glows!
Nicely done! Keep on it!
Need to take out those springs, brother.
Now, attack!
Fimblewinter, I suppose.
The magic draining out of all of us has to end up somewhere.
Ah, another of Cavassier's poems.
Huh!
Another sleeping troll, courtesy of the dwarves.
Have an interest in botanicals now? Statue of my brother. How quaint.
That's odd. The runes are dark.
What purpose does all this serve, other than a testament to my brother's vanity?
Difficult to say without an inscription, but it looks like the elves built this place together, light and dark, which means this would have been their first act of cooperation in generations.
A far cry from lasting peace. But perhaps it served as a monument. One that symbolizes the potential for peace.
This statue may have survived Freya's absence, but a truce clearly did not. Monuments are useless to those who ignore their message.
He didn't create a truce through diplomacy alone. His godhood, his very presence is what healed this land and allowed peace to take root. But once he left, he had to have known what would happen.
Well, he had good reason to leave. Some jackass convinced his sister to marry a madman.
Monuments are useless. Why restore this one?
It was hidden for some time. Perhaps now it can serve as a reminder.
Aye. Nothing reminds people of their history like chiseled, well-lit marble. Right. Normally, we'd have to provide our own. Perhaps slotting a crystal on the opposite side could shed some light on this mystery. Like we can read the inscription now as well.
The light from the crystals. It is in the sand now.
Would you look at that? Freyr's gift endures after all. Or should I say, his presence?
You are not funny.
Learn anything?
Here, the peace was fragile. Surely a bit of extra light in the desert isn't enough to make it last.
Before I met Faye, I could not imagine a life of peace. After her death, in our travels to Jotunheim, I found peace on my own. It remains my responsibility to make it last.
Perhaps the elves will find peace again one day, even without Freyr's guidance.
His presence continues to guide them, whether they realize it or not.
A key?
A key.
Must open something around here.
We can bring these two animals back to Vanaheim, or Midgard even.
Speki and Svana could use the company. We have Tenel.
It would not go well for them. Once a predator becomes accustomed to a land, it is cruel to move them.
I suppose you're right. It just seems lonely out here.
It is peaceful. They have each other. It is enough.
Another key, eh? Sooner or later, we're gonna have to find a lock to put them in.
You know, Freyr loved to breed Gulan pups in Vanaheim. I wonder if these two are the descendants of the Gulan he brought here long ago.
That explains how they got to the desert. Another gift for the Dark Elves. I wonder, how'd these two pups end up yoked to the sled?
Ever try flying in a sandstorm? I imagine Freyr showed the Dark Elves that Gulan could be trained to pull a plow. They must have found new uses for them once the sandstorm arrived. I imagine they're now bred to aid in traveling the surface.
Brother.
Light Elf, something is coming, and it's not happy. Something is coming, and it's not happy. Switching!
Whoa!
Something is coming, and it's not happy.
Guess is as good as mine. Imprisoning a drake. Can't decide whether to be impressed or horrified.
Either way, it is over now.
The elves made a few of these. They'd hang them outside their dwellings, show their support for my brother.
That boy of yours can do some damage, turns out. Maybe he'll bust through Odin's wall next.
Time to feed my plants.
Anything for Freya? Hope it's to your liking. Something in mind? And for the Valkyrie Queen? And now, Freya? Need something? Ooh, these'll look fantastic in my storage chest.
Go!
Revisiting Alfheim?
There's still a few loose ends to tie up. There's still that secret elven library in Alfheim.
I'm with you.
Enough. I remember.
Put it on one of my horns. Let's see if I can pull it off.
No.
Archive of knowledge.
No sign of the Light Elves.
For now.
Maybe they've left for the day. We can browse at our leisure.
Texts alone are not enough to end the Elven War, but restricting their access only serves those who wish to prolong it.
Taking a page out of Odin's book.
Aye, quite the advantage for the Light Elves.
All this knowledge of their ancestors, their shared history, poetry,
sealed, but there is an inscription. The consul.
Bigvir spoke of an exile of the same name. Odds are he'd like a gander at that particular text. It appears the librarian would like a word.
Lata Framborg.
Sounds like she wants that journal back.
No.
Use a shield strike! Kratos, are you okay? Skelfa!
Hiding all this knowledge away.
Our ally wishes to read this journal. We are taking the book.
She's gone.
That? Well, she's hiding again.
It matters not. The journal is ours. The work is done.
I'm impressed. Thought you were going to end her.
At last we traveled here. After Faye passed, I killed an elf of great importance. The ramifications were dire for his people. I do not wish to make the same mistake twice.
face some old ghosts. Well, your position was quite clear.
I said the dumbest stuff I've ever said. And you know how much I have to choose from.
I did it. I went back to the site of my wedding. Faced some old ghosts.
There's a day I hate thinking about.
Well, your position was quite clear.
No, I mean, because it was a day I chased you away. All I wanted was for you to not go. But I was just so angry. That day, I said the dumbest stuff I've ever said. And you know how much I have to choose from.
Yngwie, listen. I'm only trying to say, I closed a chapter today I thought I never could. Maybe every bit of anger and pain we can find a way to let go of is a gift we can give ourselves, you know?
I'll drink to that.
We have a chance to talk further, Mimir. Always nice to meet a fellow scholar. And Kratos, I understand your homeland is famed for philosophers. When things quiet down, I'd love to hear their ideas, and your own.
I have nothing to say that will interest you.
Nonsense, brother. I've heard many a wise word pass those sunburned lips.
It's all right, Mimir. My wife is much the same way.
Careful.
Quiet, but very deep.
Acceptable.
Whew! She loves me so much.
Why do you stare?
He's gonna be fine, you know.
I do not.
He's getting what he needs.
He is in danger.
And being with you, he was safe as houses, huh? Never got close to dying. Not even once?
I did not come to you for a lecture.
I know. It's on the house. My new customer loyalty program.
We will speak no more of it. Lock be opened without damaging the book. The elves in Freya's camp wish to read it.
Brock never met no lock he couldn't lick. I'll get this sucker open and pass it along to them elves with your regards. Oh, elven design, huh? Always loved their style. Lots of curves. What's the Witch of the Woods need?
Looking for something? We can head out the way we came.
Do we have to be here? Creeping me out, all these poor bastards with their souls cut up. What'll it be? And Lady Freya? What are you looking for?
What is this?
Ravens. Ones we've been destroying. Odin's little spies.
Free are we. Free of the Father. Our half-wise now belong to no other.
The Father. Odin, I presume?
I don't know. But there's definitely something more going on here.
Oh!
gift in death to his mother forever, the All-Father's breath.
Odin must have created these creatures, but how?
I haven't the foggiest. They came after my time with him. But perhaps we should continue to destroy any of Odin's ravens we find.
What's this?
Ah, a memory of war. You could use this as a training arena if you like. You'll just be fighting the recollections of enemies. They won't be able to harm you.
Prepare yourself.
Certain the trace could not still be in Midgard.
I was just there and found no trace. If Odin invited him, he must have provided a way.
No, that is not the only explanation. Tell me where we find these Norns.
I discovered some of their threads near the frozen lake. I stashed one for spellcrafting, but we may also use it to find them. Just remember, they really don't want to be found.
Well, at least things will be difficult for a change.
We should take your sled and head to the lake.
Midgard. How I've missed the freezing gusts and constant raider attacks.
Well, that's because they believe Kratos is responsible for Fimbulwinter, and that killing him will end it.
Where would they get an idea like that?
From me, of course.
Of course.
Come. Quiet. She is a friend. Now.
Better they get this from you. Once the wolves have the scent of the Norns, we'll just need to follow their lead.
I will open the gate. Stop whining.
Their fur is matted. When did you last brush them?
They are wolves.
And matted fur leads to disease. Take care of them, and they'll take care of you.
Brother, what exactly do you intend to ask the Norns?
How I may find my son. Nothing more.
You don't imagine it's a chance to clear up all this mess about prophecy? Perhaps get a second opinion on your alleged demise?
You didn't tell me you had a death prophecy?
When Atreus and I reached Jotunheim, we found a hidden mural. The giants, Fae herself, had foreseen our entire journey long ago. Who we would meet. Who we would fight. All of it, as it happened.
But you aren't dead.
That image was from a time yet to come.
I see. You've never struck me as someone who fears death. That's not the problem, is it?
No. Death can have me when it earns me.
Then maybe it's not the future that bothers you. Fae sent you on your journey, and she made sure you'd see that image at the end of it. And you're still not sure why.
I wish to speak of this no further.
Oh!
Now that we are on the lake, how will we find the Norns?
Watch the wolves closely. See how their heads point the way?
Well, the Lake of Nine has certainly seen better days. Raiders have made themselves quite at home. Not sure I've been back to these parts since our great battle with Seekrin.
She speaks highly of that fight as well.
You know of that?
She told me all about it when she found me. She believed you could be an ally. Long before I believed it.
The Valkyrie Queen. An ally.
I'm the Valkyrie Queen. As Seekrin was stubbornly determined to remind me.
I should have guessed it was Seekrin helping you recover yourself. She's so loyal, wise, clever, tall.
Doesn't take a love goddess to see where you're coming from. The oarsmen. A monument to conquerors.
Made some lovely warships, though.
Go!
You won't believe it, Mimir. This crest belongs to Fjotrlund.
Fjotrlund, you say? Now that's where Sigrun was from.
Sigrun spoke of growing up with these people before she joined the Valkyries. There must be another way around. Watch yourself.
Family's conquests. Perhaps this outpost holds some of that treasure.
Is that all she told you, Mimir?
Did she say where?
No, just that they kept it hidden.
The other staircase.
Watch it!
The Alpha!
Over there can shed some light. What? No, she never mentioned.
Is that a key?
Wonder what lock that key belongs to.
No lock. It is broken.
No broken. It's just split in half. Perhaps we could find its partner. Artifact from the River Empire. Never been myself. It's lovely. Now, where have we seen an artifact like that before?
Tyr's vault.
What did those runes say?
Secret. She loved another. A king named Helgi. Seems they were madly in love. But her parents wouldn't let them marry.
Oh, come, Mimir. You really didn't think you were her first love, did you?
Aye. Suppose I did.
Tyr used to talk about how heavy the cost of war was compared to its bounties. He felt like it was his responsibility to avoid it.
Kind of still does, in fact.
Thread of fate we are tracing.
It's not somebody's life, if that's what you mean. The Norns use it to mark their way when they're outside of the well.
The Norns live in a well.
No. The Well of Earth, their home, is hard to explain. It's in no fixed place. Entrances come and go. A place wholly under their influence, where the intangible becomes tangible. Like being inside your own mind.
But if we go in together, are we in each other's minds? Not so sure I like the sound of that.
Get off! remember which god raised her dander up.
It does not matter.
Doesn't it?
If rage is all that remains, her reasons are irrelevant.
Fine, Count of the North.
No.
Not personally. Freya's right. They have ways of discouraging visitation. Odin made his share of efforts. Wouldn't talk about what he found. Either he gave up, or he wanted to forget what he saw. Freya, you mind telling us what you experienced when you sought the Norns last time?
To be honest, the details are hazy. Like waking up from a dream. Mainly, I remember that nothing could be done to change my son's fate, which only made me more determined to try. Kratos, a raider encampment.
Shall we take care of them, brother? That's all of them.
These were coal raiders. Infamous for
eating wolves. Atreus and I rescued ours from such an encampment.
Kind of you. The coal raiders have been a blight on this land. The way they've abused its creatures. Perhaps we should do something about them.
Perhaps.
Up to you, brother. If the Norns know the future, no doubt they'll expect us to show up a bit late.
Hmm.
Brother, what of your story? You faced the fates of your homeland, yeah? The legends I heard about the ghost of Sparta were surely exaggerated.
Exaggerated?
Oh, not in the brazen bloodshed righteous fury part. The part where it said you traveled back in time itself to win a battle once lost. It strains credulity, obviously. I mean, a rumor about Thor knocking the world serpent back in history from Ragnarok is one thing.
It is the truth.
The threads of fate span all life and time. The Sisters of Fate abused their power. When I challenged them, they threatened to undo my existence. So I killed them and turned their power on Zeus.
That's the most dangerous and irresponsible thing I've ever heard. These Norns have no such magic, nor does anyone in these realms that I've ever seen.
Aye, can you imagine? If it existed, Odin would have it. And if Odin had it, we'd be five shades more fucked than we are already.
I would not ask them to change the past, even if they could. I only want information.
And that's quite dangerous enough, in my experience.
That must be Tyr's helmet from his statue.
Win mines, not wars.
Tyr understood the greatest fight of them all was the battle for people's hearts and minds. Too bad Tyr has no interest in doing either these days.
Another coal raider camp. Kratos, we should do something about them. Poor things. They can smell more danger.
The wolves fear that which can no longer hurt them.
The horrors of our past can be inextricable from the present. You have to understand that.
It's to be a sculptor from the southern lands.
Thank you.
Isn't that the spear from Tyr's statue?
Wish for peace. Be ready for war.
Well, that's astute of the elves. Tyr never sought war, but he knew he had to be ready for it.
Aye. Best be armed. Not. Impressive looking weapon, isn't it?
It is big.
How strange. I've never seen that building before.
Aye. Very strange indeed. Let's take a closer look.
This is the right area, but we can't go further on the sled. What did you find?
A list of provisions needed to prepare a meal.
A recipe? Who left that way out here?
Let's take a look at the ingredients. Perhaps the recipe will lead us to them.